That's the Mothership Connection.
Yes!
Look at him.
His goggles
look so funny.
Look at him. He's doing his little pimp walk.
Do your
pimp walk,
Yosemite's
pimp walk, dude.
Cool
cat.
You guys.
He's so young.
You hear the bass background? Listen to background. That's Funkadelic's background. That's George Clinton. And there's George Clinton like in the 80s.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Sam and Shelly and...
Jory.
Today, I wanted to introduce you to my first introduction to funk music, which was way back in maybe 1977. And we're going to start with just short examples of funk music, exactly when I discovered it in, whatever, let's say 1977, as a child. I don't know, I think I was about 10 or something. When I first heard Funkadelics, or maybe 9, I don't know. Let's get this funky party.
This is not just need.
This is knee deep.
Wait, who's the? What's the back? I can't.
The band's called the Funkadelics, and George Clinton.
Why is it Funkadelics? Not just, and then knee deep. What is
it's called knee deep. But not just is part of the phrase.
Okay.
Wait, am I in the shot?
Yeah. Oh yeah, we'll test it just to make sure.
Because before when
that'll
I looked,
be messed up.
Before
be
when
mad.
I
mad. That's why I say that just.
What are you doing here? It's a good release.
She's the freedom of desire. And when she breaks, it's the world on fire.
The girl's a freak of the week. When she dances, she gives me half the beat. She's the freak of my desire. She dances like a world on fire. Give me a happy beat. She's free.
Okay, next song. Cause this song probably go on for 10 minutes.
She wasn't funky no more.
She wasn't. Because look, it's almost 6 minutes.
This is the Parliament, which is I think also with George Clinton, but it's I think he changed bands or he made a new band. And it's no longer called the Funkadelics, it's called the Parliament. And this might be like 78, 1980, I don't know.
Okay.
Go. And when they would do performances, they would come with this ship like this.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, all the seals.
Especially the Funkadelics. I don't know about the Parliament. And I was never going because I was too young. Why does it keep doing that? That's weird.
The video now. It's not the anything. It's just the videos like that.
Oh.
Are all the songs based off of space themes?
No, but George Clinton in particular liked look spacey.
A lot of
I was a kid, so I can't tell you.
A lot of old
Mothership Connection.
Atomic dog.
Music video, yay.
It's really old. It's going to be fuzzy, you guys, because it's probably, I don't know, what, 1978 or 1980? Mm. Maybe 1980.
Let's go.
That's why there's a video, because they didn't have videos before then.
Her face, because she's like, I can't see.
Chase the cat. What?
It's okay.
Why is it so?
I don't know why it does that.
Was it too? I don't like the quality.
What can you do? That's just how quality was back then.
You can't even see.
Why must I be like that? Why must I chase the cat? Nothing but the dog in me.
All I see is someone dancing with me.
Yeah, because that's all they're doing.
All I see is color.
Why must I chase the cat? Why must I chase the cat? Nothing but the dog in me. You really can't see any dog in that video.
This video is weird. That looks like some.
The best part is the animations.
Are they all meant to be cats and dogs?
Yeah, they're all cats and dogs.
That looks so funny.
They're cats?
Yeah, you can see their whiskers.
The cats and dogs.
How do you see their whiskers?
Just look at them, and you can see like they have cat ears and they have tails.
And I remember.
And look, they didn't have animations.
It was better in the old days.
Not better, it was just back then this was considered good.
No, you could see it better than that last time. The quality just got really bad, even worse.
Animation's so
okay,
funny.
Next. Yeah, the animation's funny, huh? This is the best part of it. If I wasn't mistaken.
What are they doing?
That's their video machines.
They're just like,
what? No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no,
It's so funny.
It is funny, huh?
It's
supposed to be like an actual live one when you can see the spaceship. That one. I mean, it's going to be fuzzy, but you can get an idea what it was like actually to be there in person. I never was, because again, I was no more than 9 years old or whatever. But I saw little clips on TV and I went, whoa, a spaceship, look at that. This was then, like, no one was doing this kind of stuff. That's the mothership connection.
Whoa. The snow looks really... They did a good job looking at the Olympic fire.
Alright. Come through, 1980s and 78. Yes! Whoa.
Look at him.
His goggles look so funny.
Those look like frog goggles. Is he wearing a frog costume?
No, as you see.
No, he's just wearing a white, fluffy jacket.
White? Why is he green then?
It's just a jewelry.
Look
the
at
lights.
It, he's doing his little pimp walk. Do you pimp walk? Yosemite's pimp walk too? Cool cat. You guys don't even get it. Oh, shit. This is the 70s child. This is the 70s.
Child, anyway, so.
I mean, these days people say, you know, we don't want to always be portrayed this way, but I love it. They were so dramatic. They were so, like,
so cool.
Artistic and they like to cosplay. I mean, I like it. I mean, okay, it's not cosplay.
But. Yeah.
They like to dress up, and yeah. I mean like really costume dress up.
Yeah.
I will cut down the cosplay part.
It's not big deal.
You kind of so much.
They like to do a dress.
Because
we're all born naked, and the rest is dressed.
The big T.
Big T.
They always do this little talk with the
The big T, y'all.
The funk transplant. Dr. Funkenstein, that's right. I remember now, it's all coming back. Yo, funk is this. Oh, it's coming back.
Wait.
This might be too artsy.
What? What's wrong with it being too artsy?
The guys are characters. Yeah, the
guys have the.
The I was gonna say, yeah, was that
like
in his hair?
Like
I wish you could see it clear. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah,
and then we'd be able to see the details of the outfit. Then it would really be so cool.
Yeah, it sucks. Yeah. The camera wasn't that good.
Yeah, and somebody doesn't restore it well.
Yeah.
I think I just wanted to show you this.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Thanks you guys for watching. I hope you guys learned a little bit about funk. And by the way, what I wanted to probably bring up, and maybe we should real quick, is that funk is being used, especially their little versions, in lots of music and lots of hip-hop, especially the early hip-hop, like with Snoop Doggy Dogg. And he even called George Clinton his uncle. It's not his real uncle, but they...
Yeah.
He got his blessing to use his music. And
oh.
You, yeah, and you could maybe... Let's just do a quick...
George Clinton, what?
Snoop.
George Clinton.
Snoop Dogg.
Snoop
Doggy Dogg.
Snoop Dogg.
Well, you know, Snoop Dogg, yeah, dog. You know that? That's the same song that we just saw.
Dog.
The dog chasing the cat.
Yeah.
Oh, I know Snoop Dogg.
You heard that beat. It's the same beat that we just heard before in the Funkadelics.
How George
And it's because George Clinton gave him permission to use it in his music. And Snoop is like me. He grew up on that music and he just worshipped.
He's
the best background. Listen to background. That's Funkadelics. That's the funk. And everyone that thought was hip hop is funk. That background.
Sweet singer, so young.
He's a baby. Snoop Dogg. That is the Funkadelics. That's Chase the Cat. The song we were just singing before. I just wanted to show that to you guys. 1920. You hear in the background? Something about the music in the background. That's George Clinton. And there's George Clinton like in the 80s. And I heard it in a couple of K-pop songs. I was like, ooh, yeah, but they did it right. That was okay. I gave them the permission for George. Uncle Sam Pacelli said, it's okay, y'all did that right. Hey, everyone can borrow. I just want y'all to see where it came from.
There's a guy behind him on the back of the shoulder.
Okay, turn off. They can check Google this themselves.
There's just someone behind him on the bike.
I just want to get my reference.
Yeah, what is he doing?
He's conducting. I got Angela Hanson. Yeah, he was wearing rainbow dreadlocks before anybody was. Really. No one was wearing them.
I can't tell what time of year that was. I just saw rainbow colors.
Well, then it was dreadlocks. But he only started like in the 80s, which is like.
There's a dreads?
It's mixed with dreads and like, you know, little different things.
It looks pretty straight.
Yeah.
That's true.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that small little lesson on Funkadelics. If you have any corrections, hopefully you're older than me, and if you have any corrections, or at least more well-versed on funk, feel free to add them down below.
Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.
Like, comment, and subscribe. Bye, Pete.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.